Ladies and gentlemen, with your very kind indulgence, my wife and myself will present to you our famous nautical extravaganza. Thank you, Bert. That's right.
What's to be done with a drunken sailor, so the saying goes. We're not tight, but we're none too bright, great Scott, I don't suppose. We lost our way and we lost our pain to make the thing complete. We've been and gone and lost the blooming fleet. Has anybody seen our ship, the HMS Peculiar? We've been on shore for a month or more. When we see the captain, we should get what for? Heave-ho, my hearties, sing glory, hallelujah. A lady bold as she could be, pinched our whistles at the golden key. Now we're in between the devil and the deep blue sea. Has anybody seen our shipman?
Oh, la, 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 la.
Shut up, shut up, shut up.
Here, Jack, what? Who was that lady I saw you walking down the street with the other day?
That was no lady, that was my wife.
Wait for it.
Better to come. Yeah. Why did you leave school?
Why did I leave school, Jack?
Yeah.
Appendicitis.
What do you mean, appendicitis?
Couldn't spell it.
Oh, dear. Oh, isn't that pretty arc? It'll never get well if you pick it.
Oh.
That'll go better second house.
Yeah. Here, Jack, where was you last night?
Where was I last night?
Where was you last night?
Cemetery.
Oh, Tommy, anybody dead?
All of them.
Hey! That's a place for a minute, a place for a minute.
I got a little riddle to ask you.
You got a little riddle to ask me, Jack?
Why is getting up at 6 o'clock in the morning like a pig's tail?
I don't know, Jack. Why is getting up at 6 o'clock in the morning like a pig's tail?
Twirly. Oh, dear. Now. What's two?
Yeah, Jack. What? I've been very worried about you lately.
Pourquoi, French?
I heard you had adenoids.
You heard I had adenoids?
I heard you had adenoids.
I don't speak of it.
Why not?
Adenoids me.
Oh, what's to be done with the girls on shore who lead our toss astray? What's to be done with the drinks galore that make them pass away? We got wedgies from our first 5 beers. After that we lost control. And now we find we're up the blinking pole. Has anybody seen our ship? The HMS Disgusting. We've 3 guns aft and another 1 fore. They promise us the funnel for the next world war. Heave-ho, my hearties, the quarter deck needs dusting. We had a binge last Christmas year. A nice plum pudding and a round of beer. But the captain pulled his cracker and we cried, oh dear, has anybody seen our ship? Has anybody seen our ship? The HMS Suggestive.
Oh.
She sailed away across the bay and we haven't had a smell of her since New Year's Day. Heave-ho, my hearties, we're getting rather restive. We pulled our money, spent the lot. The world forgetting by the world forgot. Now we haven't got a penny for the you-know-what. Has anybody seen our, anybody seen our, anybody seen our ship?
Now then what? Now then what?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you don't
no,
you?
No, I don't, so shut up.
I suppose you don't know you mucked up the exit.
It wasn't my fault.
Whose fault was it then, Mussolini's?
Oh, funny, hey?
Well, I suppose you didn't drop your prop, did you? And having dropped it, you didn't have to go back for it, did you? Leaving me to prance off all by myself. Who do you think you are, Rebler?
Never mind about that. The exit was too quick.
Same as what it's always been.
It's too quick, I tell you. It's been too quick the whole week. The whole number's too quick.
Bert Bentley takes that number at exactly the same tempo as he's always done.
Oh, you and your Bert Bentley. Just because he stands your Welsh rabbit at the Queen's, you think he's God Almighty.
Bert Bentley's one of the finest conductors in the north of England, and don't you make any mistake about it.
Finest conductor, my foot. I suppose he thinks it's funny to see us leaping up and down the stage like a couple of greyhounds.
If you're a greyhound, I'm Fred Astaire.
Oh, you're Fred Astaire, all right. With a bit of Pavlova thrown in. You're wonderful, you are. There isn't anything you can't do except behave yourself like a gentleman.
Also, expect me to behave myself like a gentleman. That's a good one coming from
you,
I will
say. Oh, shut up. You make me tired.
I make you tired. I suppose it was me mucked up the exit. I suppose it was me dropped me blasted telescope.
Now, look here. Look here, George Pepper.
Will you stop George Peppering me? Why can't you admit it when you're in the wrong? You mucked up the exit. Nobody else did. You did.
Well, what if I did? It was an accident. I didn't do it on purpose.
Lily. It doesn't matter how you did it or why you did it. You did it.
Oh, all right, I did it.
Well, don't do it again.
What's on, Ducks?
Mabel Grace. She's nearly finished.
Oh, she's been finished for years, as far as I'm concerned.
What's the matter with Mabel Grace?
Well, ask the public, dear. That's all. Just ask the public.
Mabel Grace is an artist, and don't you forget it. She may be a bit long in the tooth now, but she's a bigger star than you'll ever be, so there.
Oh, you make me sick. sucking up to the top liners.
Who sucks up to the top liners?
You do. Look at Irene Baker.
What's the matter with Irene Baker?
Well, when last heard from, she was falling down drunk at the Empire Hartlepool.
That's a dirty lie. Irene never touches a drop till after the show, and well, you know it.
Irene. Was Miss Baker this and Miss Baker that the last time you saw her?
And that's all you know.
Oh, trying to make me think you've got off with her, eh? What a chance.
If a day ever dawns when you can time your laughs like Irene Baker does, I'll give you a nice red apple.
A fat lot of laughs I'd get when you write the gags.
If you're dissatisfied with your material, you know what you can do with it.
Yeah, I know what I'd like to do with it.
Can't even do a straight walk-off without mucking it up.
Oh, we're back again at that, are we?
Yes, we are, so there.
Look here, I'm sick of you and the old act. It's lousy anyway.
The act was good enough for my mum and dad. It's good enough for you.
Yeah. Well, things have changed, you know, a bit since your mum and dad's day. There's electric light now and telephones. A little invention called the moving pictures. I mean, nobody wants to see the Red Peppers for £3 when they can have Garbo for ninepence.
That's just where you're wrong, see? We're flesh and blood, we are. The public would rather see flesh and blood any day than a cheesy photograph. Put Garbo on a Saturday night in Devonport and see what had happened to her.
Yeah, you ought to know. Look what happened to us.
That wasn't Devonport, it was Southsea.
Well, whatever it was, the fleet was in.
If you think the act's so lousy, it's a pity you don't rewrite some of it.
Ever tried going into St. Paul's and offering to rewrite the Bible?
Oh, very funny. Very, 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 very funny. You're wasted in the show business, dear. You ought to write for comic cuts, you ought.
I could think up better gags than you at that. That wasn't a lady, it was my wife. Hoary old chestnuts. Probably they were has-beens when your grandmother fell off the eye wire.
And what, may I ask, has my grandmother got to do with it?
Only that she didn't fall soon enough, that's all.
Red peppers, 3 minutes.
My God, we're off. Here, hurry.
Oh, come on. Don't keep the customers waiting.
You got your cane?
Yes, I've got it.
Well, don't drop it.
Oh, all right.
Chaps who find it thrilling to do the killing, we're always willing to give the girls a treat. Just to drink at the Ritz, call it double or quits, or then we find the world is at our feet. Top hats, white specs, look divine on us, there's a shame on us, get a lane on us when we come your way.
Gad, 11 o'clock,
let's pop into the truck, now we start the business of the day. As we stroll down Piccadilly in the bright morning air, all the girls turn and stare, though we are so nonchalant and frightfully debonair. As we chat to Rosemont or Lily, you should see the way their boyfriends frown. For they know without a doubt that their luck's right out when they see a couple of men about town. As we stroll down Piccadilly, all the girls say, who's here? Put your hands to this, my dear. For it's Marmaduke and Percy Bell de Vere. As we doff heads, each pretty filly gives a wink at us and then looks down. For they long with all their might for a red hot night when they see a couple of men about town.